column here is for businesses from 500 to 2 million.
So as a teenager, definitely experienced intermittent homelessness for at least 2 to 3 years. I was not able to finish high school. So I knew I had to finish high school. I had to go to work. So I did take an equivalency, but immediately I went into nursing school. And then I went on to get my bachelor's of science in organizational management. And from there I went to get my master's in real estate development and construction minor. So I knew that school was extremely important, but I also had to eat and pay rent and work. When you don't have a place to live and you're not sure about what you're gonna eat next week, those things, you know, as you mature, those things become very important to you. Homeownership for us represents a lot. It represents the ability to be able to, you know, send your kids to college possibly, leave a legacy. But I think the focus needs to be more on permanency, ownership, whether even if it doesn't have to be a house, co-op, condo, ownership, and a path to get to that ownership. I mean, I've developed houses in my community. I've done all kinds of additions in my community, and it's really important to me. You know, when you see developers that are from outside the community and they come in and they just, you know, throw anything up, I try to be very cognizant of, you know, the landscape of the community, the people, what do the buildings look like.
You know, I met Alexis a little over 2 years ago, and when she had built or just finished Baldwin Park, and I was astonished and fascinated by, you know, the work that she had put in to build this beautiful condominium. Working for a leader that's willing to push through any obstacle is just something that motivates me day in and day out.
Income statement, balance sheet, the third page, you have a sample of industry overages.
I need you to get the
concept. Yes, exactly, that's what I'm trying to
do. Okay, great.
You don't get this type of education in school. I can definitely tell you that. You can go get 3 degrees. It doesn't add up to what you learn here, because this is real world. And how do I make these principles apply to what I'm doing right now to make a difference? The leadership component is what really spoke to me, and I felt that we could really utilize that in my company. The ability to be with other entrepreneurs from the community with similar, some with similar businesses, some with not, but we're all in business, similar revenues, similar stages in our business. That's amazing, because we could both sit around and fuss at each other about payroll and insurance. A number of us have grown quite a bit since we started. We were selected to do several scopes of major interior finishes on the tallest building in Harlem, the Victoria. So that was that happened while we were here. So we're doing like the flooring, the self-leveling, cabinetry, countertops. The Victoria is a hotel, and they have apartments and affordable apartments. And they also have theater spaces and parking.
New York has just become astronomically unaffordable, and to have a project such as this that has 50% of the units as affordable is amazing. That's unheard of. People ask me all the time that from the neighborhood that see me in the hard hat, they're like, well, oh, you're part of that project. Oh, I guess we're getting kicked out. And I said, no. Being able to do something in this community is amazing. I live in the community. She lives in the community. And just to have a part of this historic project, I'm living that dream.
That's how you stabilize a community. When you're in programs like this and you're able to share, maybe there's another entrepreneur that can't get in access to Columbia, but I have that knowledge that I could share with them.
I hope to one day, you know, start my own company in the Bronx, just like Alexis did here in Harlem, and then hire within the community. I feel like in the Black and Brown communities, we're only shown, you know, whether it be through the media or whatever means, there's only certain avenues that you can go to really be successful in this country. And real estate has never, at least in my opinion, never been something that's been, you know, on the forefront of people's minds to say, wow, this is something I can actually do for not only a career, but for, you know, my like passion. So I hope to show the younger generations that this is, you know, another avenue.
And that all goes back to community. And that's why these programs are so important. You're here with entrepreneurs of the community. And so your pulse is, your finger is right on the pulse. And that's how you're gonna make a difference.